Eanswythe, did you say her name was?
How do you pronounce that?
Eanswythe, I heard.
She set up the first nunnery in England.
Her bones lie in the St Eanswythe Church, her jawbone and some of her skull.
The bones are slight and thin.
How old was she when she died?
Got under the nunnery!
What happened to the nunnery?
I've got an orb!
Some say the minister went over the cliff.
I heard it was pillaged by Vikings.
Was her mother Emma? If that is true, why was her name rubbed out then rewritten?
She was the daughter of Eobald.
Was she the daughter of Emma, or his first wife of Aegon? Is this what caused the rift with the church?
I hear she performed miracles.
May the stream flow uphill.
Where was the stream? Does it still exist?
I heard she compiled a library in the Vale, and the Venerable Bede consulted the library when researching the birth of Christ.
Myth, legend, fact, fiction. Myth, legend, fact, fiction. Myth, legend, fact, fiction.
The year is 597 AD. Queen Bertha, a Christian, opens the door for Pope Gregory to send his envoy, Augustine, to Kent to convert the pagan king Ethelbert to Christianity.
Who goes there?
I'm Augustine, sent by the Holy Father to convert Kent to Christianity. I've come to see Queen Bertha.
You leave Bertha out of this. Anyone who wishes to speak to the Queen shall speak to me first.
King Ethelbert, are you willing to accept the Holy Mother Church?
Yes, I am willing.
I baptise you, my son, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 Kent became Christian, and all remained tranquil until 616 AD, when Ethelbert, on his deathbed, hands the throne to Eadbald, his son. Eadbald rejects Christianity and converts Kent back to paganism. Word reaches the Archbishop of Canterbury, who visits Eadbald and persuades him to revert back to Christian faith.
Eadbald, I pray we accept the Christian faith for the sake of the kingdom and the people of Kent.
But what about my wife?
Were you wed in the eyes of the Lord in his house with his blessings?
No, we jumped over the nearest broomstick.
Oh dear, then a Christian wife you shall have.
Eadbald leaves his pagan wife and marries Emma. Together they have three children, two sons and a daughter, Eanswythe. Time passes and Kent once again remains at peace. When his daughter comes of age, Eadbald is keen for her to marry a prince of similar status. The King of Northumberland has a son of suitable age. This marriage would create a good political alliance for Kent.
Eanswythe, my daughter, I have found you a suitor. You are to meet him and to be wed.
But father, I wish to be a bride of Christ.
Listen, my child, think of Kent. It would be good for the kingdom. The meeting has been arranged.
I will meet him in the grounds of the nunnery. If it's God's will, I shall be wed.
Eanswythe meets the suitor in the grounds of the nunnery, which is being built but is not yet completed. There is a beam which is too short. Eanswythe proposes, if the prince can pray to his god and grow the beam to its full extension, they will be wed.
Will you marry me? Will you marry me Will you marry me?
No. If you can complete the being to its full extension, I will marry you.
Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
O Heavenly Father, complete the being to its full extension, and I will devote my life to Christ.
Oh, it's not to be for me.
The prince tries and fails and makes a retreat. Eanswythe completes her first miracle. The nunnery was completed, and Eanswythe led the nuns in their daily devotions. She performed further miracles, such as healing the sick.
Stop shouting at the seagulls. Amen.
The water ran from the holy well, down from the hills, through Cheriton High Street, past Beyond Chicken Shop, past Westcart Station, past Beyond Morrison's, through Guildhall Street and into the nunnery. Died at a very young age, at 24. She was remembered for all her good deeds and thus was named a saint.
Eanswythe, did you say her name was?
How do you pronounce that?
Eanswythe, I heard.
She set up the first nunnery in England.
Her bones lie in St Eanswythe Church, her jawbone and some of the skull.
The bones are slight and thin.
How old was she when she died?
Got one of the nunnery!
What happened to the nunnery?
Some say the minster went over the cliff.
I heard it was pillaged by Vikings.
Was her mother Emma? If that is true, why was her name rubbed out and then rewritten?
She was the daughter of Eobald.
Was she the daughter of Emma or his first wife a pagan?
Is this what caused a rift with the church?
I heard she performs miracles.
Made a stream flow uphill.
Where was the stream? Does it still exist?
I heard she compiled a library in Verbale, and the Venerable Bede consulted the library when researching the birth of Christ.
Myth. Legend. Fact. Fiction. Myth. Legend. Fact. Fiction. Myth. Legend.